Hello, welcome to Vocab Wednesdays, and this is Chris with Magoosh. Today's theme is commonly misused words. That is, there are many words in the English language that are misused by people all the time. People think they're saying one thing and they're actually saying another. What a travesty. Speaking of which, the word travesty, doesn't mean tragedy, though many people use it in that sense. Travesty, rather, is a really poor, bad imitation of something. Oftentimes we hear this in the context of justice. So let's say there's a court and the judge is totally corrupt. He's accepted $100 bills under his, I guess they wear robes, whatever they wear. And you're supposed to have this wonderful, unbiased judge who's supposed to carry out this objective justice, yet it's an absolute sham. It's a travesty of justice. Not necessarily a tragedy. Different things. I don't confuse them. Next, we have a word that people will find very aggravating once they realize they've been using it incorrectly. So here's the thing. I use it incorrectly just now, the way I'd use travesty. When you say, oh, this fly is buzzing around my ear, it's so vexing, people love to say aggravating. The aggravating fly, get away from me, you aggravating, annoying insect. But aggravate actually is a synonym with exacerbate, which means to make worse. And so you can have a situation that's been aggravated. For instance, if a police officer pulls me over for speeding, and instead of apologizing and saying, yeah, I'm sorry, I was obviously going over the speed limit, if instead I argue with the police officer and say, no, your radar detector is probably wrong, I'm only aggravating the situation, meaning he's probably not going to be very nice to me and probably going to slap me with a double fine on my ticket. Next, we have a word that people think means one thing but means something very different. Enervate, which seems to have gotten poor Mr. E there, didn't quite make it, but that is an E. Enervate does not mean to energize, though it sounds like that. Energy. However, enervate is the opposite. It means to suck the energy from. Now, the GRE is really tricky, and there's actually another word in English that may actually come up. It's innervate, and that's spelled I-N-N-E-R-V-A-T-E, which actually means to energize, but it is the opposite of enervate. And I know all these subtleties in the English language can be very enervating, just suck you of all your energy, but remain positive. Finally, we're not done yet, we have refute. And I hear people use this often in the context of, oh, I'm going to disagree with you, I'm going to argue. I'm going to refute you. Refute doesn't mean that. It means something very different. It means to disprove strongly. So if there was a claim that the random object in the sky was a UFO, and people are twittering or tweeting about it, it's up on their Facebook, and then all of a sudden it turns out it was actually a balloon by the military, then it turns out the claim that it was a UFO has been refuted. It's been completely disproven. Though, of course, some would argue that actually an alien spacecraft. But again, to refute does not mean to argue with, but means to disprove. And that's it for this week, and I'll see you next week for Vocab Wednesday.